receiving yards, receiving touchdowns. Let's give it break. I'm shattering that though. It's a lot of money. Why are you mad like that? All right, training. Yeah, I'm still training every week. That's gonna keep happening. Because I need to make sure me and Carson are, you know.
Fellas, we've got to have a great practice today. There's no other option. We've got 17 weeks. We strap it up and we get better each week. This is one of those times you got to take advantage of it, all right? So let's get at it.
Here we go, Pac-Man. Ladies!
All right, so let's get this started, man. Like that right there? What is that? There we go. That's how you throw the football. Throw him to me, I catch him. Woo! Should have been a pass interference. We won't talk about it. Right, oh crap. Catch it, E. Hey. That turkey ain't ready for me. Bro, I keep doing this every, like, training, and then it gets to, you know, that real thing, and they start putting their hands on me. I don't understand. I got cleats on my feet, jersey on my back, helmet on my head, ready to attack. We go get some red skins. We go get some skins, man.
I'm the coach. You're locked into the NFL on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we'll see the new man in DC, Case Keenum, and the Washington Redskins as they take on Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles. With that, let's get up to the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. We're standing by for the call. Our Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach. It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene in South Philly a few moments ago. Boy, the city of brotherly love is fired up. They're saying, fly, Eagles, fly, as they get ready to match up with the Washington Redskins.
Yeah, we're ready.
So happy to be with you, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis. And we thought it would never get here, but here we are back together. It's opening weekend of the 100th season in the NFL.
So much football to talk about. That's our main focus. But how about how much happened in the offseason? Rules changes. Overtime rules were discussed in a big way. Some superstars changed addresses. There's a whole lot to talk about in the NFL in addition to this game we're getting ready to watch.
Dak still here. My guy. That's the bro right there. WP. This season about to do numbers. We about to do numbers, man. I'm staying true to my routes. Coach, I do whatever you tell me. You know what I mean? And I'ma make plays. That's the big thing. Whatever you tell me and I'ma make plays.
Pac-Man.
You can't block me.
Yeah. Oh,
that's now a two-time 1,000-yard rusher for the Bears. This is Jordan Howard. A loss of two there. Second down. Plays like we just saw there. That's why they're up right now. The defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs or putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though.
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. Yeah. Hey, it kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, sniff it out, and finish it off.
When you give up points on the opening drive, in this case a field goal, you'd hate to go three and out. They avoid that.
They do, and it's also walking that fine line mentally, too.
Yeah, boy, get out of there.
Because you want to emphasize to your team exactly what you said. All right, we gave up a field goal. Let's go back and at least equal that, guys. But if we don't, you don't want them to feel like it's the end of the world, either. Nice that they were able to pick up the first down there. Help them relax a little bit.
Now it's the all-purpose back. This is Darren Sproles.
Yeah.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield.
Don't see
up front, the struggles continue for this offense among the line. What can they do? Change the play calling? What?
I think part of that, yes, changing some of the play calls, some screens, some draws, some misdirection. You want to run any type of a play that will influence these guys to continue.
Come on, defense. Good job. Good job.
A reminder, coming up later tonight, the Patriots unfurl their 6 banners. They play host to their rival Steelers. And then on Monday night, that's the 1 week into the year where you get 2 games to wrap up the week. Texans and Saints from New Orleans in the early game, then Broncos and Raiders. Vic Fangio's coaching debut and the Raiders' final season opener in Oakland. That's the late game, 10:30 Eastern. To throw again on second down. Wentz. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle. Going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that. They might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
10 yards there and an Eagle first down.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been pulled down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
7 yards to pick up on the pitch and catch.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and you can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
16 yards, a first down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Only a yard on the completion. It's second and goal.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
What the hell? And it'll be intercepted. It's the 2014 NFL interception leader, Glover Quinn.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count.
Oh, man, that is so stupid. Like, that was the dumbest pass.
So on fourth down, the Redskins will call on Tressway to punt it away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. This is taken at the 15. 12 yards on the return that time. And the Eagles will have it, taking over at first and 10. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it to the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try to move the football.
From the 31, Wentz. It's complete. It's Sproles. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve. And that's what they did on that play. They went there. But the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
Looks like he throws
that was third down game. Throw, but it misses but like, the target incomplete.
The my route was supposed to go. Yeah. I'll see you. I'll see you. It's the weirdest thing.
Right, here we go. Here we go. Sweetie!
On first down, Wentz. And he comes back with one complete. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver. The coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did. And obviously, they liked his measurables. Otherwise, they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they're bringing your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Now a play fake here on first down. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. The former Pro Bowler Glover Quinn there making the play.
But that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45.
Kenny had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. Now throwing on third down there, but he cannot connect. On first and 10, here's Wentz. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. And once more, he was looking for Alshon Jeffrey, but it'll be second down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass.
That was an okay hook up there with his tight end, but unfortunately, they didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. An Eagle first down there, Wentz to Ertz, and the names that end in TZ.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
A gain of six there on first.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. And welcome back. We are in the city of brotherly love, Philadelphia. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four.
All right, here we go, baby.
Again, it's Wentz. Oh, he's got it wide open, complete. And he is brought down, but not before reaching the 30. 22 yards there, a first down. Even though this offense doesn't have a single point to its name, they're not totally out of this game yet. A touchdown here, they could be in business.
And how about that last play? Now they get momentum going, so you don't have a big advocate. Get back on the line of scrimmage, throw another play out of play. You've got rocked on their heels.
Chewing up big yardage, another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball on the receiver before any defender can step up and field it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter about winning.
Is it a positive?
It is a positive.
Okay.
About winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. You were right. They've done just that, and look where it's gotten them.
It's part of the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big
one more
key.
Shot.
And this one's playing
Let's
out.
Take that shot, man.
That time the completion goes for 4 yards, and we're set up with a third and goal.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, a ball may come your way.
And this is going to result in losing yardage.
Get the field goal, yeah. Please. Thank you. Stop them one more time. Oh, you turkeys.
Here we go. Pac-Man. What's going on?
Tight end right. Tight end right.
All right. Where we going? Right,
Wentz now on first down. This one complete to Sproles. And from the 25, they work this to the 29. A gain of 4. Second and 6, just inside the 30. 3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over.
Oh, yeah.
They'll look to throw. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk at a 45. 16 yards, a first down.
Yeah, like, I think like
that gets him the first down, but they still got to move quickly here.
Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. He'll look to throw. Caught by the tight end, Ertz. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. From midfield, here's Wentz. And that'll be incomplete. The Pro Bowl tight end Zach Ertz, the intended target, and it's third down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here?
Boy,
or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this
what
situation.
Is that?
Need to.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well. Fourth down now, and defensively, Charles, you know, they're just asking this crew for one more stop.
And you know that they're feeling the momentum right now, but they have to be very careful not to get over-exuberant, over-excited, and blow an assignment and give up the big first down.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is...
I don't even know what to tell you, bro. That's perfect. He threw the ball away.
So hail to the Redskins as they get the victory here. And with that, our journey begins, Charles. Week one in the books. Going to be a great season.
Oh, man, so much to look forward to. Isn't it nice to get a really good game right out of the gate? Preseason behind us. All these games count now, don't they?
Yeah, this is the exciting time with just 1 week gone and plenty of weeks to come. So for the Redskins, it wasn't always pretty, but they do eke out the week one victory here by a field goal. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for Philadelphia, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat. And they'll try to turn it around next week as they head to Atlanta for a matchup with the Falcons.
Whatever, bro. Stop talking to me. That's how pissed I am about that game. Turkeys, man. Turkeys, I swear. I got any points. All right, well, that's it for week one. 3-point loss to the Skins. Like, what? That's stupid, man.